Hello, everybody, and welcome back to DayZ. And once again, I've got a slight head start on you in that this character has been alive for a little while, and I'm a murderer. A double murderer. I can explain, if you're willing to believe me, and I would not begrudge you for not believing me, but I am going to take the risk of explaining my story of how I came to murder two people and get some extremely important equipment, and let you know that it wasn't really my fault. So, I was in Cherno. I spawned outside of Cherno, right about here, and ran into Cherno. I looted some coffee shops until I found a revolver. And then I went up on top of this clock tower building that's overlooking the center of Cherno. And normally there's some loot up there, backpacks, stuff like that. But while I was up there, I ran around towards the front of it, and then all of a sudden some guy laying on the ground just starts unloading on me with a huge gun. So I'm like, what the fuck? So I run away. And I say, what the fuck, bro, stop, on voice chat. And he's like, okay, sorry, I got scared. And so I'm like, what? You fucking shot at a guy with a gigantic gun, like, 12 times because you got scared? So I'm like, you know what, I don't want to fuck with this guy. I don't want to run around either of these corners because he's there with a big gun and I've got a fucking dinky revolver. So I'm like, fuck it. I say, okay, well, I'm just going to leave. And if you leave me alone, that would be awesome. So I did. I left the building, I climbed down the ladder, and I started running around away from there through the streets of Cherno. And the next thing I know, I'm hearing that exact same gun, bang, 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 and bullets hitting near me, and I'm like, that motherfucker. So I went back around, and as I'm climbing up the ladder again, you know, possibly towards my death, I'm thinking, what in the fuck is some guy doing on top of a fucking sniper nest in the middle of the most populated area in the game with a gigantic gun shooting at people, or shooting at anything? What is he doing there if he's not there to murder people? So I'm like, whatever. I climb up this thing, and I see him there on the edge of the building shooting at something, and I'm like, this dude's got to go. So I shot him in the head a couple of times, and he's like, why, dude, why? I was your friend. I swear to God, he said, I was your friend. I'd never met the guy before in my life. All I knew was that he'd shot at me. So I killed him, and it turned out that it was a murder, and he'd probably never killed anyone, at least not on that particular person, which was weird and made me feel a little bit bad, especially because he was my friend, according to him. I'm looking down these stairs because I'm on top of Zub Castle, and people do like to come here. So I could be killed while telling you this story, but I think it's worth telling. So I go and I loot him, and I got a fair amount of stuff off of him. He actually had a different gun than this. I got this off of the second guy I murdered. I'll explain that in a bit. He had an M249 saw and a bunch of bullets for it. He had night vision goggles, map, GPS, toolbox, military flashlight, entrenching tool, compass, matches, all this stuff. He had this coyote backpack and a PDW with some clips for it, which I need to switch out at some point, but I'm not going to bother with right now. Whole bunch of extra rounds and stuff like that, and I'm like, okay, so I just killed an extremely well-equipped dude who failed to kill me. So I go to climb down the ladder, and as I get to the bottom of the ladder, there's a zombie there, just one, and he thwaps me once, and it breaks my legs and knocks me unconscious. So I go down from 10,000 blood, or 11,000 blood, or whatever, to being at about 800 blood by the time I had killed that zombie and bandaged myself. So I'm laying on the streets of Cherno. That is some karma right there. Like, you kill someone and immediately a zombie nearly fucking kills you. So I had to run all the way out of Cherno, blind as a bat. All I could see was white and blur, and I'm just running all the way up here. So I ran all the way out into this field here where I found a cow. And I killed it, and I slaughtered it, and took its meat, and I cooked it, and I ate it. And I also found a goat, and I ate that meat too. And I got myself up to 1,100 blood just from eating the flesh of some animals. So then I headed over to Kozlovka, and I climbed up on top of this building here. And I look down the street, and right here about this building, there's 15 or 20 zombies or so eating what looks like two people, except one of them's not moving. So I'm thinking to myself, this dude just killed this other dude and all the zombies in the town came. The one guy that was alive was laying on the ground and he was shooting the zombies with a pistol and they were just all beating on him. I knew he was dead. I just started shooting out there, thinking, hey, maybe I can get a bandit kill to equal out this murder I have, because it looked like he had killed that guy. But no, that was another murder. He was dead anyway. I just happened to shoot him right before he died, and so I got a second murder. He had the M4 CCO on him, and a few other things too, including some smoke grenades and some medical supplies that I wanted. And that was an angry zombie, angry at a person, and it's extremely unlikely that that person is me. Yeah, I'm using third person too. Zombie there. I am becoming one with the DayZ community. You have to become what you hate in order to survive it. And I'm not above doing that. Oh no. No, I do what I have to do to survive. Including some things I didn't have to do. Like murdering people. So for now, I have a plan. My plan is, right now I am, from here I went all the way over to, where's Vishnoi? There we go. I'm right here. I don't know why it doesn't show me that on my map. I've got a freaking GPS. It's weird. Oh, it's because I'm playing on a higher veteran server thingy. Anyway, what I want to do is, I want to go all the way north here to Berezino, because I know that along this coastline here, it's possible that boats will spawn, and I would like to go there. And what is that marker? That's weird. Somebody put a marker there. And I would like to get a boat. So I think that's what I'm going to do, and hopefully that'll keep me out of harm's way for a little while. It's going to be difficult because this server is damn near full. There's 45 people on it right now. And those are the kind of servers that I like to play on. As much as everybody there's a gunfight going on outside. I don't think it involves me. Not yet, anyway. But I have a feeling it's about to. Yeah, this is where it's gonna end, right here. Because there are people very close by. I don't think they were shooting at me. Although they probably could have seen me up there on the roof. I just heard another gunshot. Fuck, am I gonna get out of here? It's a pretty bad place to log out. I think I'm gonna go. I think I'm gonna go and run for it. Because there's people here with guns. I can't actually see down there. Oh, God. There's a whole bunch of shit in here, but I don't really want any of it. I just want to get out of here alive. This is not the way that I want to be heading. But it is the way I'm getting out of here. Because it's one of the most covered areas. Pretty tough to shoot somebody from here. But with the server being as populated as it is, it's unlikely that anywhere I go will be, you know, empty. So I have to be really, really careful. That also means I'm going to die pretty quickly. Probably. The only reason I'm recording this is on the off chance that this one guy will manage to survive for a little while. Already knowing that I've shed my pacifist bonds. I'm not interested in you, piggy. I just want to get the fuck out of here. I've shed my pacifist bonds, and I've shed blood in the name of my own profit. Yeah, this is a bad place to be running, but I don't really have much choice. Where the hell were those shots? They didn't sound like... It sounded like two people shooting at each other. I was on that roof, and as I was walking down, it sounded like it was hitting the wall of the place that I was in, too. All scary stuff. None of it good. I just need to be moving. And this is the direction I need to be moving in, so... Sometimes it's better to be running through an open field than crawling through a covered area, because, when you're moving slowly, sure, it can be easier to spot you. But if you do get spotted, it's much easier to hit you. The only real fear I have is if I'm running straight towards someone. Almost any other angle and I should be pretty difficult to hit. And if they do hit me, I should be difficult to finish. Holy shit, Abraham Lincoln was killed. It's horrible. I guess the Civil War is over. I do like to think that at some point the mod would try to go in the direction of having some sort of political groups. Factions that you could join willingly that would allow for a little bit more teamwork through voluntarily, of course. You know, if you wanted to volunteer to be in a group or a faction, then you could, and then you could begin doing things like policing areas, and all of that would require a more limited number of servers, though, or at least the dedication to play on a single one server. I don't really know if that would be possible, but what I do know is that I'm going to start auto-running, and you can do that by holding forward, if you're in the Steam version of the game, by holding your run... Actually, I need to eat and drink. Well, not yet, actually. I need to figure out which direction I'm headed. Okay, that's north. I'm not headed in exactly the right direction. I'm going to look at my map here. And I forgot I don't have a marker, even though I have a goddamn GPS. I'm not willing to find the coordinates here, because they don't make any sense to me. I don't know. I was just at Vishnoi, which is south. There we go. I was here. I should be here-ish. Okay, so wait. How the fuck do I find that? 068091? Whatever. Hearing some noises that I don't like. Ultimately, any kind of vehicle would be good to find. Well, I'm going to be heading northeast, because that's the way I need to go anyway. And if you're running the Steam version of the game, turn on auto sprint, and then hit shift tab to open up the Steam interface, and then bingo. Hands free! Neat little trick. Still don't know exactly where I am, but there's a little barn up ahead, and I may stop in there to eat and drink and see what's inside. You know me, I just can't resist a good barn. Well, there's zombies in it. As far as loot goes and what I need, I'm mostly just looking for food and water. I don't think there's any specific thing that I need. Except for a tent. I would love to get a tent. So that I could store some of my supplies somewhere. This is gonna get loud. Oops. Awfully passive, these zombies. Is someone telling me to check my fire? Is someone telling someone to check their fire? There's a hatchet there, so at least that's something. Apparently these zombies are on my team. I don't know what that blue-on-blue bullshit even means. Some tin cans. Some firewood. More cans. More cans. A hatchet, cans, and something. That might be another can, but I can't really tell what that is. It's another can. Alright. I'm going to use these cans here to switch my pistol out with the one I've got in my backpack. Pull out the PDW and the PDW clips. Close that bag. Equip the PDW. And I got all three clips in here good. And I will put my revolver and the two measly clips I have for that in my bag. There we go. Now we have a fully automatic handgun. Well, it's an Uzi. Let's not mince words here. We have our M4. So if we do need to make a transaction with another survivor, it should be successful. I wish I could tell where I was. I think I might be near Guglovo or something. I was headed northeast, so that's not it. It's not Mogilevka. Yeah, I headed northeast from there. This could be it. Yeah, that looks like it. Yeah, there's a little shed. Okay, so I think I'm right here. There's a road going this way, heading northeast. So that means I could go to Lesnoy Krebet, but I don't think there's anything there. Novi Sabor is directly to the north of me. And if I keep heading on, I'll just keep going until I hit Gorka, and then I'll actually go past Berezino, so I might need to change my direction at some point. But I think this is where I am. If the road out here is a certain type of... Yeah, that's definitely exactly where I am. This guy's got painkillers on him? What a weird zombie. I'm getting a little concerned about the chains here on this server. I don't really like it when servers lag this much. Alright, I'm going to be heading east. I thought I would need to eat and drink there, but I'm not quite at the point where I'm going to need to do that yet. Oh, I know that field. That's that sand-looking field. The zombie's pretty far away from home. Just for reference, for the time that I'm missing on the recordings here, it's about 1:17 in the afternoon, and I'm going to be running through the Black Forest soon. Just running northeast. Not my fault this road was here. I was here first. Put that road there. Alright, I've been running for... about 3 or 4 minutes, and there's a fork in the road right here. This should be the spot that I'm at right now. Unless I'm... No, I'm here. I'm right here. Yep, this is exactly where I am. There's a little building up there. I'll be going in between Gorka and Polana. There's a church and some other stuff in Gorka, but that's not really what I really want. I really want to be heading east to get to the coast here, so I can follow the coast all the way up here to see if I can find boats or other vehicles. I'm going to be wanting to head up to Black Lake, that far north, at least. But now we know where we are, so I'm going to be switching to head east. Long-ass run. Oh, I should probably stop while I'm here and eat some food and stuff. Yeah, why not? Let's have a cow patty. Yeah, that's right. And I'll drink from my water bottle in the hopes that I'll be able to find a place to fill that up at some point. And there we go. Ready to move. Alright, it is about 125 and 126. And there is Pilana. I will not be passing through. I'm not interested in whatever the hell is there. But what I will be doing is heading this way and a little bit southeast of here. Because there's a factory north of Dolina that I would like to check out. I've done it before in another video, but tools and equipment were disabled in that version of the game, and it's come a long way since then, so I'm really curious to see if there's anything different there. So I imagine there might be some good stuff. It looks like I'm going to make some friends while I'm here, though. Hopefully I can lose them in the bushes. But yes, Pilana is possibly... not necessarily occupied, like, by a fucking army, but it's possible that there are some people there, and I don't really want to mess with that right now. So, heading east of Pilana, I basically went through here, and I should be able to meet up with a road at some point here, and that'll take me to the factory. In theory. Coming over this ridge, we should be able to see either the road or the factory. There's the road. Let's see if my map skills are correct. Factory should be somewhere on the other side of those trees. Yeah, I see it right there. Bingo. Let's approach through this little grove here. So I'm going to want to take a look at it before we go in. Got a shady little spot right here with a chest-high wall to take a peek. We're going to need to get another look at it, but... so far, so good. All I see is rubble. I know there's a way in through the back there, so I think that's how I'm gonna get in. It's a really good view of the stairs there. Possibly the best view I'm gonna get. There is some stuff in there. All I see is scrap metal, though. But no people. And I'm fine with that. Fine indeed. Could have been a bird I saw, but I thought I just saw something move right around those bushes over there. It's probably that bird's shadow. You know those people that tell you you can never be too paranoid? I've never played DayZ and had stuff to lose. I'd be a little bummed out if this guy died. Without going down without a fight, you know, or if he were to fuck, go down without a fight. That would be a bit of a bummer. Oh god, already. Somebody's been here. These doors are open. Helicopter engine. Fantastic. We're gonna do a top-down. Check the roof first, spend as little time up there as possible. Whoa, oh, fuck. Try not to break my fucking legs in the process. I would love to find a tent, some barbed wire, or camouflage clothing. There's nothing up here, and I'm fine with that. Want to spend any time up there if possible. And here. Okay, I guess that wasn't. No, there's scrap metal right there. There's some scrap metal. I don't know what I could do with that. I imagine you need it to repair cars or something? Is that a stair? No, that's not a stair. Stairs are here. Here we go. Kind of surprised there's not tents and shit here. Not like lootable, you know, deployable tents, but player deployed tents. This seems like a place where you could stash some stuff in relative safety. Another fucking helicopter engine. Just what I always wanted. Looks like nothing has changed here. Still fucking empty as hell. Except for some scrap metal and helicopter engines. Neither of which I even remotely have any use for. I'll take a body bag for a second. Yeah, okay, we're fucking completely empty. Little building here I could look in. There's my friend Mr. Zombie. He's the greeter here at Nothing Mart. Welcome to Nothing Mart. I hope you don't find what you're looking for. Engine parts and a jerry can. I have to remember that. Okay. Thanks for that. Hope that doesn't mean that I just entered into an area where some guy's wearing, like, a super cool army helmet or something. I don't think there are helmets in this game. Either way, we are done here at the factory north of Dolina. So, I'm gonna continue heading east. And slightly northeast. To Berezino. Or Bepithrinho, as the game's sign calls it.